My name is Tom. My pronouns are he, his, him. I do have a podcast that I work on that tries to amplify the voices of the nationals where I'm from, who are, you know, trans identified or trans people. I'm also, you know, working on, I guess, just content, information, education, stories geared towards that specific nationality, that demographic. The work that I do would be mostly trying to educate and trying to uplift voices, really. Just like put an amplification on the stories. Most of the time, I don't look for anything quote unquote transformative. I'm not looking for, like, you know, the big stories. Most of what I do and what drives me is just getting those stories out there. No matter who you are, every single person has a story. And I would like the idea, I would like to see more of those stories heard, you know? So it's just the people behind those stories, getting them out there, getting more people who might not know or understand, and also making it obvious that we're not a monolith. Because by the time you hear about 20 stories from different trans people, you would see that in as much as there's similarity, there's a lot of difference as well. So I guess breaking barriers for trans people, for me, it comes mostly from my background, where I'm from. It's it's one of those countries where people get killed and imprisoned for being like me. So breaking barriers to me would look like changing that. Living in a place where trans people and all queer people are free, are happy, are respected, are valued, and just protected, really, at least in the opposite of what we have going on right now. And then speaking about that, I guess it makes me think about, you know, like I said, where I'm from, people are still getting killed and jailed. So when I hear about, you know, anti-trans legislation where I'm at right now, especially, you know, ones that fight healthcare, that try to prevent us from getting life-saving, gender-affirming healthcare, it really bums me out, because I know growing up, I never thought that I would get to a point. I never thought that I would, you know, be somebody who had access to that. I do right now, and let me tell you, I'm freaking out. I know the first time I ever, like, got the information that it is something within my grasp, I was screaming for like 2 minutes straight. I couldn't do anything else or think about anything else. You know, hearing that there are people out there who want to take that away from us, especially thinking about people who don't even have it right now or struggle to get it, it drives me, really, but it also, there's a lot of feelings there. Trans history in the making looks like, I mean, to me, it looks like more people, more and more of us doing things that we love, that we care about, as big or small as that may seem, depending on where you're standing, and just making impact, you know, making impact that we can look back on and be happy about and rejoice about and be like, you know, this was a point in time where this was becoming more visible and more accepted, and just more sources for joy and pride in the trans identity. How I feel about discussing rights in history, like trans rights in history in the classroom. Like I said, I would have had a world of benefit. It would have done so much for me if, you know, growing up in schools and classrooms, I heard about people like me. I heard about trans people. I heard about trans rights. I heard about trans history. You know, I was told that we've existed, or trans people, because I would have known by that I was a kid or something, like that could be the excuse, but I would have heard that trans people have existed from time, and it would have made self-acceptance so much easier. It would have made knowledge and growth, you know, so much easier for me. It would have improved my journey. So I think about all the trans kids who know, or maybe don't even know yet, who could benefit from that. I hope we get to a point where just queer history and queer rights in general are taught, because it is honestly just a silencing, like an attempt to keep us in the dark, an attempt to deny our existence. That's what I see it as. And it's often cloaked under the guise of protecting children, but there's really nothing to protect them from, because these people exist. Some of them are in that classroom, and they deserve to know. You cannot continue to deny our existence. You cannot continue to deny our rights. Thinking about the little boy I was, let's say, like 13 years old, I would tell him to keep going. He's always been a fighter. I don't think I would tell him to change much, but I guess I would just give him like a glimpse, like a better glimpse of hope. And, you know, I would ask him to live out loud earlier, much earlier than, you know, that he did, but that's totally fine. I would just give him that glimpse of hope and let him know that his struggles are not going to be in vain. My biggest dream is just really to amplify for the purpose of improving. I want to amplify my voice. I want to amplify trans voices specifically. I'm trying to avoid saying the country that I'm from, but specifically, you know, from that place, the people there. I have gone out in search of community. I never knew growing up that there were so many of us. And until I started looking and I started finding, and it's been such a pleasure for me, you know, just getting that those people together, forming a sort of online community that I've been able to form. It sucks that I didn't get that till I left that country, but I have it now, and it's such a joy for me. It really is. So my biggest dream would be to just build more and more of that, so that, you know, they're aware of that support they have, so they're aware of that community they have, so they know that, you know, people like us from this country exist, and we're so powerful, and we're deserving of all the things that we desire. Everyone has a voice. That's really what it is for me. Everyone has a voice that they can use if they want to, at whatever stage of their life, of their safety, of their progress. So yeah.